right here. One more. Okay. Are you consumed with making love? Thank you.
12 Pro with 5G is here. Order now on a network with 5G coverage in all places.
I would rather kill you than not get to spend my life with you.
Good shot. But oh.
guys will come with me to feed these placement.
Pizza and root beer on Friday night? How can I possibly miss out on such a nice evening?
Great. So, does that mean I'm late? Almost your boyfriend?
Not really, it just means you were right.
About what?
Do you prefer guys that don't have a speech impediment?
You heard that when I was talking to Bobby?
It happens. It's a mystery.
Dr. Michael Hunter is a world-renowned forensic pathologist. He's performed over 4,000 autopsies, and today he's the chief medical examiner in one of America's biggest cities. Working closely with law enforcement, Dr. Hunter specializes in unraveling the cause of suspicious deaths. Gary Coleman died in mysterious circumstances. Is this the sad film the child star off the rails? Or is there more to the story? Using all of the available medical evidence and police reports, I'm going to build a picture of Gary's final days and hours and determine exactly what happened to him. May 25th, 2010, Santa Quinn, Utah. 3 days before Gary's death. Gary's at home playing with his model trains. This has been a hobby ever since he was a child. There was no greater passion for Gary than his model trains. So he would periodically find himself immersed for hours and hours creating another space and another kingdom for his model railroad, and that was his ultimate choice. mounting medical bills following a series of health problems have left him nearly bankrupt.
An initial glance through Carrie's medical history tells me he was plagued by a number of health issues for most of his life. Determining which, if any, contributed to his death won't be easy.
Gary Wayne Coleman was born in Zion, Illinois on February 8, 1968. His parents, W.G. Coleman and Edmonia Sue, hailed from humble beginnings in the rural Deep South. The couple worked together in a laundry at a Chicago hospital, putting themselves through night school to give their son a better start in life.
Well, if that's how you get you with all the hair.
Young Gary showed early promise as a performer, and in 1977, at the age of 9, he was cast in a commercial for a Chicago-based bank. Gary was actually discovered by a talent scout who was working for Norman Lear.
You know, you can never have too many human dolls.
Norman saw the footage and said, I've got to get that kid to Hollywood. And that is exactly how Gary was discovered. Within a year, Gary had been handpicked for the lead role in the new NBC sitcom, Different Strokes. Gary played Arnold Jackson, one of two brothers, a rich white businessman, after their mother died. His impossibly cute face and comic timing made him an instant, and he quickly became a star.
They're telling me about the story about that young kid.
And he was just adorable. And then he would say something, and you just bust a gut laughing.
The most striking thing about Gary is his height.
He died.
When it came on, I was like, hang on, isn't he? And then I went, oh, yeah.
Different stroke. Yeah, he died of a heart attack, I think. He died very young.
Gary is 5 years old. After 2 years of waiting, a donor kidney has finally been found. He undergoes a 7-hour operation to have it transplanted.
That is just a challenge that most people can't even relate to. When you're a young child facing that kind of horror, it's unending. It's with you every day.
The kidney transplant was a success, but it meant that he had to take powerful immunosuppressant drugs to keep his body from rejecting his image.
One time he commented to somebody that he took so many pills, he was surprised he didn't rattle when he walked.
Yeah, I think it was only about 4 years ago he passed away. Thought of a stroke or a heart attack, one of them. I know one of them. So that's what your kidneys were doing. What his were doing. The only problem is, some reason or other, your blood thing split and caused your kidneys to clear. That's what the doctor said, because you've never seen anything like it. So I thought, oh well. Happened.
The effects of the medication Gary took or his restricted height had anything to do with his death. But the combination of arthritis and the powerful steroid explained his short stature and his unique look. If Gary had healthy kidneys, he would have. His small stature, chubby cheeks, and ability to play a character held him to superstardom.
He became the star because he had this ability to say a line that would just lay everybody out. It was a self-taught genius.
By 1981, Gary had become NBC's highest-paid comedy actor, reportedly raking in around $70,000 per episode. Gary's parents gave up their jobs to manage their son, and made themselves 20% of his earnings. The show was a huge success, but behind the scenes, the cracks were starting to appear. 1983, Metro Media Square Studios. Gary is 15 years old, but he's becoming increasingly frustrated. Playing a younger character, the mounting pressures of fame, and his failing health. Gary himself was carrying the show. He was everyone's music and video. He was fed up with being tutored on set. He wanted to go to a regular school. He wanted to be like a normal kid.
Freedom!
Is he letting us out yet, mommy?
It's saying he can, but wear a mask still, and no more cases found. Saying zero, so not even one overnight. They never said anything yet. About traveling anywhere. Penguins! Whoa. I'm guessing this taking me 1 hour to do, or longer. Got a bit more to go. Oh, okay, a little tiny one. Okay, let's see. Any more places on this? Needs to be fixed up. Aha, found one. It says King Island Taz.
So he's going to let us out yet? Or do we have to call into our corner and say, Mummy, he's not here today.
He didn't say anything yet.
We have to go get a dummy and take it out like Jim Rummy. I
want to
make a cozy
booker
Barney dummy.
Say what?
I don't know, I'm just saying. I just throw it in for the sake of throwing something.
Yeah, can hear that.